Hello, my dear students of class 5th. Today we are going to start the new chapter, chapter number 7, ratio, proportion and percentage. Okay, for Sambodh class we have learned chapter 8 already, that is length. This was skipped. Why? Because Pravinya and Pythagoras students were not there, so this chapter is there for all three classes. So I have skip that. Now we are going to take chapter 7. So ratio, proportion and percentage, these three are different concepts. Okay, ratio is different, proportion is different and percentage is different. So these three concepts we are going to learn in this chapter. Okay, today's lecture we are going to learn the first concept, that is ratio. What is ratio? Okay, so what is mean by ratio? Actually this is new word for you, ratio, completely new word. Okay, so read that again and again, ratio. Okay, so what is mean by ratio, how to find the ratio, that we are going to learn today. Pay attention very carefully and try to understand the concept. Okay, when you we will move forward, you will come to know it. It is very easy concept. And when we will move forward, when we practice more and more examples, you will come to know, you will understand it. Okay, so don't worry. Just what you have to do, pay attention carefully and try to understand. Okay, so see here on the black on this board, I have written some sentences. For every 2 cups of flour, take 3 eggs. This is a recipe of making cake. For every 2 cups of flour, how many eggs are needed? 3 eggs. Means if there are 2 cups of flour, there should be 3 eggs. Okay, so if there are 4 cups of flour, then how many eggs are needed? If there are 4 cups of flour, how many eggs are needed? See, 2 2s are 4, so 3 2s are 6. If there are 6 cups of flour, how many eggs are needed? See, 2 3s are 6, so 3 3s are 9. So according to that it will increase. So see, what is this, you know, for every 2 cups of flour, take 3 eggs. Whenever you see the see video of recipe, that chef tells you for every 2 cups of flour, take 3 eggs. Every 2 cups of flour, take 3 eggs. That doesn't mean you will take 2 only cups and 3 eggs. You will take according to the person you are making for. Okay, so this is what 2 cups of flour and 3 eggs. This is what basic proportion, basic requirement, that is for every 2 cups, how many eggs should be there? 3 eggs. Understand? See, second example, one bench for 2 students. One bench for 2 students, or for 2 students, how many benches require? One bench. Okay, then if there are 4 students, then 2 bench. If there are 10 students, then 5 benches, right? So this is what basic for one bench for 2 students. 5 boys in one room. See, there is hostel, and in each in hostel there are some rooms, and in each room there are how many students? How many students can be accommodated in that in each room or in one room? 5. 5 boys required one room. Then if there are 10 boys, then how many rooms are required? 2 rooms. If there are 15 boys, then 3 rooms in this room. So this is basic. 5 boys in one room. Okay, so all these three sentences reflects the concept of ratio. Okay, so see, I have written here two dots and 3. 1, these 2 dots and 2. 5 and 2 dots and 1. How to read this? 2 cups for 3 eggs, 3 eggs for 2 cups, 2 students for 1 bench, or one bench for 2 students, 5 students in one room. Okay, so these all three sentences actually tells us the ratio. Okay, still you have not understood ratio, I know very well. Now see, how to read this? 2 is to 3. Here 1 is to 2. Okay? Here 5 is to 1. 3. Okay? In spelling I am writing. So whenever we say 2 cups for 3 eggs, or for every 2 cups, 3 eggs, that means 2 is to 3. 2 is to 3. 1 bench for 2 students, that is 1 is to 2. 5 boys in 1 room, that is 5 is to 1. Okay? So this is the presentation of ratio. This is the presentation of ratio. 2 is to 3, 1 is to 2, 5 is to 1. Okay, these 2 dots, you know, these 2 dots between any 2 numbers represent ratio. Understand? So now see, 2 is to 3. In another way, how can we write that 2 is to 3? 2 upon 3. 1 is to 2. How can we write in another way? 1 upon 2. Or 5 upon 1. Okay? 2 upon 3, that is same as 2 is to 3. 1 upon 2 is same as 1 is to 2. 5 upon 1 is same as 5 is to 1. Now this we know, we have learned this in this form, we have learned in the fraction, right? 2 upon 3 means 2 divided by 3. 1 upon 2 means 1 divided by 2. 5 upon 1 means 5 divided by 1. Okay? So ratio means nothing but division of two numbers. Division of two numbers. This is one of the aspect of ratio. Ratio means division. Ratio means division. Division of two numbers. Okay? If those two numbers are, for example, x and y, if those two numbers are x and y, then the ratio of x and y will be x upon y, correct? X divided by y, and same as x is to y. X upon y is same as x is to y, whereas x and y are any two numbers. X is any one number and y is another number. So their division means the ratio. Okay, so this is one of the aspects of ratio. This is not full concept of ratio. Again see, now see, 2 is to 3, 1 is to 2, 5 is to 1. This is, as I say, this is basic. Here, instead of 2, if there are 4 cups, then this will also increase. Okay, 3, 2 is 6. If there are 2 5s are 10 cups, then here 3 5s are 15 eggs are necessary. So this is what you know. See, 2 is to 3, same as 4 is to 6, same as 10 is to 15. Okay, but this is basic. This is what? Basic which we can tell, we can use to tell others. Whenever that chef or that cook tells you the recipe, how does he tell you? He or she doesn't tell in this way, like 6 eggs for 4 cups of flour. No. He or she tells you the basic measurements or basic requirements, that is, for 2 cups take 3. Okay, so this is the basic. So ratio is, you know, it is very, it is what? Basic. That means what? It is the simplest form. It is in simplest form. Whenever, see, if you want to write 4 is to 6, that is 4 upon 6. This is not basic. This can be converted into simplest form. Both are divisible by 2, correct? So 2 2's are 4 and 2 3's are 6. So their basic is 2 upon 3. Their simplest form is 2 upon 3, correct? 2 upon 3, that is 2 is to 3. Understand? Similarly, if you take here for one bench for 2 students. Here suppose number of bench can be increased. Suppose there are 15 benches, then how many students will be there? 1 15 is 15, so 2 15 is 30, correct? 15 benches required for 30 students. But this is not again basic, or this is not simplest, lowest. This is the lowest, 1:2. 1 bench for 2 students, this is the lowest. Means if there is 15 upon 30, these both are divisible by both are divisible by 15, correct? So 15 1s are 15 and 15 2s are 30. 1 upon 2 is the simplest form, lowest form, basic. So 1:2 is the ratio. 15:30 is not the ratio because it is not single lowest term. Okay, 15 is to 30 or 15 upon 30 is not the ratio. 1 upon 2 or 1:2 is the ratio. Okay, why? Because 15 upon 30 is not the lowest term. It can be reduced, it can be converted into simplest form. Okay, so, and the simplest form is 1 upon 2. So 1 upon 2 or 1:2 is the ratio. Okay, this is another aspect of the ratio, that ratio is always in simplest form. Ratio is always in simplest form. Now simplest form means lowest term, okay, that we have learned in the fraction. Turn the pages of textbook, go in the chapter of fraction and check there. We have learned the lowest term or simplest form of a fraction. Okay, it means if there is 15 upon 30, then lowest term is 1 upon 2. We have divided both the numerator and denominator by same number, then we get the lowest term. Okay, and we have to keep on dividing till we get lowest term, that is 1 upon 2 cannot be divided further. Means 1 and 2 are not in any same table, so this is the lowest term. So ratio is always in simplest form. This is another aspect. Understand? So what we have seen, ratio means what? Ratio means division. Ratio means division of two numbers. That is x upon y or x is to y. Okay? Then ratio means, ratio is always in simplest form. 2 upon 3 is same as 4 upon 6. But 4 upon 6 is not ratio because it is not in simplest form. This is ratio, 2 upon 3 or 2:3 is the ratio. 1 upon 2 is equal to 15 upon 30. But 15 upon 30 is not the ratio because it is not in simplest form. It is not in lowest term. So this is not ratio. This is ratio, 1 upon 2. That is 1:2. Okay? Similarly, 5 upon 1 is equal to 20 upon 4. Correct? 5 4s are 20, 1 4s are 4. But 20 upon 4 is not ratio. Ratio is 5 upon 1 because it is in lowest term. So, what is mean by that? Ratio is always in the lowest term, simplest form. Okay? So, these two things keep it in mind about this concept ratio. Other things we will learn while solving the examples. Okay? Ratio means division and ratio is always in lowest term, simplest form. Another one aspect is, ratio doesn't have any unit. What is mean by the unit is, I'll rub this for some time. Suppose we have to find ratio of 20 kilometer and 10 kilometer, okay? 20 kilometer and 10 kilometer. So this is not the ratio, this is not in lowest term. So there to find the ratio, what we need to do? We need to divide both the numerator and denominator by their common factor. That is 20 and 10 are both are divisible by 10, correct? So 10 2s are 20 and 10 1s are 10. And what about this kilometer? I have not written why, because kilometer divided by kilometer, when we do it, it is cut. Okay, it is vanished, disappear. So this ratio, this unit, kilometer, kilometer cannot be forwarded in the ratio. Ratio doesn't have any unit. If there is rupees, if there is kilometer, meter or kg, that unit is not forwarded in the final while finding the ratio. Okay, so ratio is simply 2 upon 1, that is 2 is to 1. It cannot be written as 2 kilometer is to 1 kilometer. No, 2 is to 1. Understand? So ratio doesn't have any unit. Ratio doesn't have any unit. Okay? Ratio doesn't have any unit. So these are the three aspects of the ratio which you have to keep it in mind. Ratio means division. Ratio means simplest form. Ratio means no unit. Okay? So now what you do, you know, write name of the concept ratio and these three aspects right there. And in bracket write x upon y is same as and or x is to y. Okay? This need not write. Pause the video and write that. After that we will see first practice, that is 7.1, in which we will solve the examples which are based on the ratio. Okay? Let's solve practice 7.1. The first question is, find the ratio of the following. Two numbers are given and we have to find their ratio. Okay? So, you know that ratio means what? Division of two numbers. Ratio means division of two numbers. Okay? Three steps are there. Ratio means division. Then ratio means simplest form. Okay? And ratio means no unit. Now see, first we have to find ratio of 60 and 20. That means what? We have to find ratio of 60 and 20 means what? We have to divide 60 and 20. Now see here. Here also 60 and 20 means first number is 60, second number is 20. So whichever is first number, that you have to write O. We know that ratio means division. That is when two numbers are there, x and y, so ratio means x divided by y. Similarly, two numbers are 60 and 20, so their ratio means 60 upon 20, correct? 60 upon 20. Now, this is not the ratio. This is one of the representation. Ratio means lowest term. So, we need to find the lowest term. Lowest term, simplest term of 60 and 20. Now, let us think, 60 and 20 are divisible by which? Same number. Here what we can do, okay, both 60 and 20 are divisible by which? Same number. Can you guess? Are they divisible by 10? Yes. 10 6 are 60, 10 2 are 20. But is there a common factor of 60 and 20? Is there another number which is greater than 10 by which 60 and 20 are divisible? Yes. Is it there? Yeah, it is there. Which? 20. There is 60 in table of 20 and 20 also in table of 20. So, think greatest number. Okay, that is called highest common factor, HCF. Okay, so if you divide both the number by their HCF, then within one step we get the lowest term. So, see here, HCF of 60 and 20 is 20. So, let us divide both the numerator and denominator by 20. 21 are 20, 22 are 40, 23 are 60. So, 3, 60 divided by 20 is 3 and 20 divided by 21. So, ratio is 3 is to 1. How to read this? 3 is to 1. Okay? This is the lowest term and this is the ratio. 3 is to 1. So ratio means division, ratio means simplest form. Here there is no unit. Next, 45 and 15. Find the ratio of 45 and 15. That means 45 upon 15. Correct? Now 45 and 15, both are divisible by which same number? Let us see 45. Let us divide 45 and 15 by the highest common factor to find the lowest term. So what is highest common factor? What is HCF of 45 and 15? What is that? 15, correct? 45 is there in table of 15 and 15 is also there in table of 15, correct? So 45 divided by 15, 15 2s are 30, 15 3s are 45 and 15 1s are 15. Here also same. What is ratio we have got here? 3:1. Remember, the numerator you have to write first and after in the last there should be denominator, okay, after hyphen. Now see here, 5 meter and 200 centimeter. Here there are units. Now see, before finding ratio, if there are units, then check or make sure that both the given numbers should be in same unit. Understood what I am telling? If you have to find ratio of two numbers and units are given, then make sure that, make confirm that both the numbers should be in same unit. Now if you see here, phi is in meter. Phi is meter and 200 is in centimeter. Are they in same unit? No, they are not in same unit. So we cannot find ratio of 5 meter and 200 centimeter. But we have to find, then what is the option in front of us? Yes, we can make them or we can convert them into same unit. Now see, phi is meter, so can we convert 200 centimeter into meter? Yes, we can convert. How? See, 5 meter, okay, and 200 centimeter. You know, 1 meter means how many centimeter? 1 meter means how many centimeter? 100 centimeter, correct? 1 meter means 100 centimeter. So if there are 200 centimeter, means how many meter? 200 centimeter means 2 meter, correct? Now both 5 meter and 2 meter, both are in same unit. Now we can find their ratio. Understand? If two numbers with different unit, if there are two numbers with different units, then we cannot find their ratio. Instead of that, we can convert them into same unit and then we can find their ratio. So your ratio is 5 meter and 2 meter. So 5 meter upon 2 meter. Okay, this meter divided by meter cut, so the unit cut, okay, remain 5 upon 2. Can we find the lowest term, or this is only lowest term? 5 upon 2, can we find its lowest term, or this is only lowest term? Yes, this is only lowest term, because 5 and 2, 5 is prime number, so it is divisible by 1 only, and 2 is also prime number, so if you divided both the numbers by 1, it will remain as it is. So 5 is to 2 is the ratio of this 5 meter and 200 centimeter. Understand? Don't find direct ratio. 5 divided by 200, wrong, because 5 is meter, 200 is centimeter. So their units are not same. Both the quantities, both the numbers should be in same unit. Then only we can find their ratio. Remember this. Next, 125 paise and 2 rupees. Again, there are two quantities, two numbers with different unit. Here, 125 are paise and 2 are rupees. So, they are not in same unit. So, first, we need to make them in same unit. See, 125 paise and 2 rupees. Now, 1 rupee means, rupees 1 means how many paise? 100 paise. So rupees 2 means how many paise? 200 paise, correct? 200 paise. So required ratio is 125 paise upon 200 paise. Paise, paise, cut. Okay. 125 and 200. Both are divisible by which same number? They are in table of 25. You should know table of 25. 25, 1s are 25, 2s are 50, 3s are 75, 4s are 100, 5s are 125. So 125 divided by 25, answer is 5. and 25, 200 divided by 25 answer is 25 8 are 200. Table of 25 is very easy. 25 50 75 100, then again 125 150 175 200, 225 and 250. So 5 upon 8 is the lowest term, so ratio is 5 is to 8. Okay, ratio of 125 paise and 2 rupees, that is 125 paise and 200 paise is 5 is to 8. In the ratio, I have not written paise paise unit. It is called already, okay? So, ratio is lowest term, ratio is division, ratio is, ratio doesn't have any unit. Okay? So, these 4 examples write in your notebook. In the first question, there are 2 more examples. 45 second, 1 minute and 80 and 240. 5 ratio of those 2 examples, okay? See next question, question number 2, it is word problem, pay attention, open, already you have opened page number 125, that is practice 7.1, I am reading the question, put your finger and repeat afterwards me in your mind, okay? Raghav got 650 marks out of 1000, Raghav got 650 marks out of 1000 and Rahul got 275 marks out of 500. Express their marks in the ratio. Now see, two boys are there, Raghav and Rahul. What? Raghav and Rahul. Okay, Raghav got 650 marks out of 1000. Out of 1000 total marks, he got 650 marks. And whereas Rahul got 275 marks out of 500. Now see, we have to express their marks in the ratio. Means marks means obtained marks, 650 and 275. Okay, these are their marks which they have got. We have to express in the ratio. But see, these 650 marks are out of 1000 and these 275 marks are out of 500. So, can we compare their marks directly? Can we compare that 275 are less than 650? Can we compare? No, because these 275 are out of 500, not out of 1000. So, what we need to do first, you know, before finding their ratio, what we need to do first, these marks, these are out of 500, that we need to convert into 1000. So, 500, you know, 500 2s are 1000. Correct? So, this 275 we need to multiply by 2. So, now here we got 500 2s are 1000 and 2 5s are 10, 1 carry, 2 7 are 14 and 1 15, 5, 1 carry, 2 2s are 4 and 1 5, 550. Now, see, now these two quantities are same, two terms are same because 650 out of 1000 and 550 out of 1000. Now we can find the ratio. Required ratio is, Raghav's mark and Rahul marks. Marks of Raghav upon marks of Rahul. Okay, see, this is very important. First, whose marks you have to write? Marks of Raghav and then marks of Rahul, because Raghav's marks are given first and Rahul's marks are given later. Okay, marks of Raghav are 650 and marks of Rahul are 550. Okay, and we have to find the ratio. So what we will do, ratio means division, there 0 0 is there at the end in both the numbers, so that we can cut, remain 65 and 55. Now 65 and 55, both the numbers are divisible by which number? Yes, they are divisible by 5. So if you divide 65 by 5, what answer we get? 5 on the 5, 1 remain, 5 came down, 5 3 is 15, 13. And if we divide it 55 by 5, what answer we will get? 5. 11, 5 is 15. 55. Okay. So the ratio is 13 upon 11. That is 13 is to 11 is the ratio of their marks. Understand what we have done? Two boys are there. Their marks are given. Raghav's marks are given out of 1000. And Rahul's marks were given out of 500. So they were not in same quantity. So what we have done? 500 we converted into 1000. So 275 also converted similarly. So we got 550 upon 1000. And after that we found their ratio. Okay. Next. Example number 3. Sunit is 1.50 meter tall and Sumit is 1 meter 20 centimeter tall. What is the ratio of their heights? Heights of two boys are given, Sunil and Sumit. Okay. Sunil and Sumit. Height of Sunil is 1.50 meter. And height of Sumit is 1 meter 20 centimeter. Okay. So height of Sunil is given in meter and height of Sumit is given in meter and centimeter. What we will do, you know, both the lengths we will convert first into centimeter. Now 1.50 meter, you know, 1 meter means how many centimeter? 100 centimeter. Okay. So 50 meter means actually it is 1 meter and 50 centimeter. 1 meter and 50 centimeter. That means what? 1 meter means 100 centimeters. That means this 1 meter means 100 centimeter plus this 50 centimeter. That is 100 centimeter plus 50 centimeter. So total 150 centimeter. Means 1.50 meter means 150 centimeter. Now see, Sumit's height is 1 meter 20 centimeter. Means this 1 meter means 100 centimeter and 20 plus 20 centimeter, that is 100 centimeter. 1 meter means 100 centimeter plus 20 centimeter, which is equal to 120 centimeter. So height of Sunil is 150 centimeter and height of Sumit is 120 centimeter. So required ratio, first write this, write according to same steps, required ratio, first write here required ratio, so you will get idea which number is divided, which number should be in numerator, which number should be in denominator. Required ratio is height of Sunil upon height of Sumit. Okay, don't change the sequence. So height of Sunil is 150 centimeter, whereas height of Sumit is 120 centimeter. So centimeter, centimeter cut. This zero in the end of both the numbers, that will be also cut. 15 upon 12. Now, guess 15 and 12 are divisible by which same number? They are divisible by 3. Correct? 3 5s are 15, 3 4s are 12. So the ratio is 5 is to 4. 5 is to 4. 5 is to 4 is the ratio of height of Sunil and Sumit. 5 for Sunil, 4 for Sumit. Understand? So in today's lecture we have learned a few examples of ratio and these two word problems. Watch the video very carefully. If you don't understand, watch it again. And you have doubt in this, you can ask me. In tomorrow's lecture, we will see the remaining examples. Two examples which I have given for homework. Solve that today itself. And ask me doubt if you have. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.